Do you want a little joie de vivre?
Unfortunately, I've got a wife. Howdy, mister.
Hello.
Do you want
Are
to
you
make
lonely?
Me very happy?
Oh, hello. Damn fine weather we're having, ain't it?
I'm a very good lover, sir. Interested?
Don't even think of trying to get behind me. I got eyes in the back of my head.
I'm a little
I do beg
man,
your pardon.
Unfortunately.
¿Qué tal?
Those bands are getting more bold. Getting closer to the border town.
No hay hoyo más profundo que la boca.
Pues hasta luego.
Hello.
Let's go. Come on. Might as well. You little beauty.
Hey, fellas, I think there's somebody out here. Nobody outshoots Woody Swenson. I got Viking ancestors.
You give it up, Chesson! That was there getting your head cut.
Thank you.
this, I'll bet you a good price. You wanna do this the hard way, huh?
That no good piece of dirt. Thank you.
Where is he? I'm a terrible mother.
Good. Hello there.
Oh, on that counterfeiter last week.
Woo!
It was pregnant.
Surely not.
Howdy, mister.
You need something for that gout? I wonder what I need.
down! Tough one, ain't you?
Mind. I ain't got all day.
Okay, I'll take it.
Here you go then, partner. Good luck out here. God damn it!
You stink! Come on, let's get this over with. Lie still. Slow up. Howdy, miss. What are you doing out here?
I'm thinking.
Have I seen you before?
Oh, yes, I think so. On the train from Blackwater, perhaps.
Yeah. Yeah, you were talking with the preacher.
Yes, sir, I was.
I don't know if it's so safe out here, miss.
Oh, Jenny. You can call me Jenny. All right. I'm safe because I have faith. So, faith can move mountains. That's the whole point.
You're trying to move a mountain?
Oh, no, I can't do anything. But with faith, I can achieve great things. I know that. I know it.
You want me to take you back into town, ma'am? You seem kind of unwell.
Oh, I get such clarity out here. I see things purely. The world is so beautiful.
And full of things that'll kill you, including illness.
Nothing's gonna kill me, sir.
Well, take care then.
They're about to hang my buddy, and he ain't done nothing wrong. You gotta help.
Load up now.
Come on.
Hey.
world coming to?
If it ain't me, it's someone else.
Come on.
howdy there. Well, protecting yourself, it's the American way.
Hi there.
I hear that Marshal pisses in a squat, if you catch my meaning.
How nice to see you.
Hello. The Marshal ain't no man in my eyes. Nice doing business. A fine transaction.
Jeb Murphy at the gun shop lost his son to cholera.
Anything you need, just holler.
I heard they did that new telegraph.
Save your hot air. I could have guessed that myself.
Blessings to you.
Sorry, miss. My fault.
Excuse me, sir.
Miss Jenny. Miss Jenny. Don't look like the Almighty's much inclined to help you out here. I was kind of worried about you, so I brought you some medicine.
Oh heavens. Oh, praise you, Lord. I knew you'd save me.
Excuse me?
You see, it was only through His will that you were ordered to save me. Tell me, were there angels in your vision?
Jenny, can I take you back into town?
Oh, praise you, Savior. I knew you'd save me.
Will you come with me?
Oh, I'm fine here, mister. I'm in heaven. Evan!
Yeah.
How are you, mister?
Howdy, mister.
Casey says she's the child, but I ain't touched her in one. You, kind of...
Travel safely now.
Mister, one day I'm going to use it.
This'll fetch a good price. What can I say, partner? Let's go! Easy.
Well, hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. And we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle was take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. But you tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. Sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie. We got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston. Right, now you got some rope on your belt. Let's see if we can't wrangle some horses.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
Ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret it sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eyes.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy the ride?
I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. And there's few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland.
Marston!
dragging him in. That's it. Hold him nice and still. Now, Martin, rope him. That's it. Now hold on to it.
You'll have this.
I got you. I got you now.
Keep at it, Mr. Marston.
Here we go.
Come on in, cowboy.
I'm glad. He's quite a character.
You have a good life here. A life I want. For me and my family, I mean.
We don't have a lot anymore.
You have enough. It's one that gets so many folks in trouble.
It'll sap your spirit and make you poor. But it's straight. And it's decent.
There's no better night's sleep than after an honest day's work.
It's no wonder you look so tired, then.
Some deck must be shy of Joker, Miss McFarlane.
Broncos.
That was fun.
I think you could be a fine rancher one day, if you can bear to stop killing people for a living.
Sure.
Come on, boys.
Amos was saying some horses have been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We could really do with those horses. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's head for Armadillo.
You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure asked a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, country vibe.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of chief governesses Paul hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He never admitted, but my pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much.
It's kind of painful. But she's never far from my thoughts. Let's go.
There's my boys. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's drive them up the canyon. Careful, he almost knocked me clean off. Yeah.
Come on!
Whoa there! Relax now! Nearly there! Almost got you! Relax now! Hold on! Come on! Calm yourself.
Thanks for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal.
I heard some dead cannibals took a young lad off with them.
Sounds good to me.
Saloon's a great place to get to know everyone.
Really?
Howdy!
Thanks.
You want to spend some time with me?
Excuse me.
Answer to a higher authority.
You don't gotta ride that trail again.